Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So yeah, thank you so much for 15,000 subscribers. It means so much to me. And so once I reached 15,000 subscribers, I did ask on my Instagram that you can go follow me on Instagram. Ask me when I hit 15,000 subscribers, I asked on Instagram that, you know, ask me questions, like I'll just answer, I'll do a Q&A type of video. So yeah, this video is that I'll, you know, do my makeup alongside answering your questions. Just, you know, so that I can create a look instead of just sitting and talking. I thought this would be a little more fun. So yeah, let's get started. So the first question is, you seem to be very strict. Sorry, Dee, I love you, but yeah, you seem to be a strict. I don't know why, I do get that a lot. But even in real life, I think people think that, like, until they know me, they think like I'm very reserved or anything like that. And once they know me, they'll think like, you know, Ocha, you're also same dumb like me only, na?
What?
So like that, I don't know. I don't try to be strict. I don't know. I really don't know. When I see my videos, I don't feel like I am strict, but I do get that a lot from you guys as well, that, you know, I seem very serious, seem very strict. I don't know, guys. I don't know what else, like, I don't know. Maybe, like, you know, in future, like, I get more comfortable with the videos or something, then a little different perspective might come. I'm just going in with the Lakme Absolute Gel Primer. I'm not gonna show you the product like from talking. Everything will be in the description. So I'm just going to apply it on the nose and like wherever I have pores. I've been loving this primer. It glides on really well. The next question is, when did you start this blog? I mean, was this after your engineering or while engineering? So I think I told this a couple of times before. So I started like posting tutorials when I was in my second year of college, I think. So I think that's 3 years ago. But back then I just posted for the, like, you know, fun. Only my friends and like followers were like friends and family, so only they used to see. But I seriously started doing this after engineering. So last year June, once I completed my engineering, I got into this real, like, seriously full time. The next question is, how do you handle hate comments? When you know you're on a public platform, I knew, like, you know, when if I get to a certain point where I have a certain number of followers, I will be subjected to hate. But I don't know, like, you know, you can never be prepared for it. So I had this one of my video go viral. Like, I had almost 1.5 million views for that video. So so what happens when your video goes viral is a number of click. Obviously, everybody knows. A lot of strangers see you who don't know you, who don't know your personality, who don't know your work. So they just see one video and they kind of judge you. So for that video especially, I got a lot of hate. And that was initially, that was, I guess, 1 month or 2 months into this career. And I saw that, like, it was too much to me initially when I started, because I knew there was going to be hate, but I was not prepared for it yet, because it has just been 1 month and I've not seen that kind of thing. It affected me a lot. Then I turned off the comments on that video, and I don't know, I'm blessed to have friends who I can talk to. So I spoke to a couple of my friends, and like, you know, it's just that about me sharing. I don't expect them to say any advice, because it's nothing like I don't know, or, you know, nothing could help unless I am okay with it. But yeah, you know, I think one thing I always wanted to change in me is that I don't want to take the pressure or, like, you know, a thing to, you know, make. I cannot make everybody understand. I cannot make everybody, you know, change their perspective. I cannot, like, have that control or think that, you know, why is certain, because sometimes there's some incident happens, something happens, like, let it be a small issue, and there are a lot of different perspectives to it. Some perspectives which are very cruel. When it comes to a female issue, a lot of you know, males are filled with, like, misogyny, patriarchy. The thought process is so wrong, and that frustrates me and it affects me mentally. But again, I have to keep telling myself ki I cannot, you know, change everybody. It's not in me. I need to not, like, you know, make other people affect what I, you know, think, like, unless and until I am, like, you know, okay with where I am, what I am doing, that shouldn't bother me. But at the end of the day, I think all of us are humans. It does affect sometimes, but I am lucky enough to not get, touch wood, that not so much hate except for that video. Other than that, like, you know, comments come like, why do you wear so much makeup and everything. But I think like now I am okay with that. I don't really care. I didn't really care about such comments before also. I knew those were going to always be there. Makeup shaming is a real thing. And I'm fine with it. I cannot change somebody's perspective on it. And I cannot, you know, make them understand that I'm not forcing you to ask, like, you know, wear makeup or anything. It's just my face. So what is your problem? So all these things are like, when you cannot change somebody's opinions about certain things, I think it should not affect you. Like, you should try and not let them affect you. Something which I had to learn was that you cannot please everybody. There is always going to be one person who's always going to be against you, no matter, even if you, like, you know, sacrifice yourself for somebody else, somebody is going to say that is wrong. So you know, it is like that. It is all in the perspective. People say, you know, it comes with the job, you have to be okay with it for other people who address hate comments, but it is not supposed to come with the job. And I guess that is what other people are trying to say. Just because somebody is on a platform, public platform, no person has the right to hate them or give any you know, unwanted opinion or give any criticize. It is not, you know, necessary. That is the perspective we live in today's world, which is actually wrong. And that is what people who address hate are trying to say, but I think people are not able to understand that even till date. So the next question is, I'm 19 and doing engineering. I love makeup. Is starting a blog too soon? You inspire me a lot. I think for this profession, it's never too soon. You can always start right then and there. It's never too late as well. I do wish I started my career like when I was 19, like when I really started posting. I wish I took it more seriously and started YouTube also, like did IG really seriously, because I would have been a far better place in terms of numbers. But I'm really happy where I am. But yeah, it's never too soon. You should always start. Like, if you have time and that passion, you have to start. You can start whenever you want. Favorite pizza topping? My favorite pizza topping is nothing. I don't know. I'm very, very basic when it comes to pizza. I love my normal cheese pizza. Like, wherever I go, I just order my margarita. I love pizza how it's supposed to be. It's not like I don't mind having like other things. But yeah, I love my plain cheese pizza. Do I believe in law of attraction? I don't, you know, have like the entire idea. I just know what law of attraction means. So I'm going to answer on the basis of that. So if I'm wrong, don't kill me. So according to me, I think I do believe and I don't, because there are circumstances which sometimes it does not work. Like, you know, I'm talking about extreme cases, but the law of attraction basically means, for people who don't know, that if you have good thoughts, good things will happen to you. But what I think is, law of attraction makes more sense to me is because, see, when somebody has really good thoughts, their mind is at peace. Okay, so whatever happens to them, they take it in a positive way. They don't have this, you know, so much rut going on in their brain, like jealousy, insecurity. It's so many things. Okay, so when you have good thoughts in your head, I think your mind is at ease, like your heart is at ease. You feel like very you know, calm, like you don't have so many things to bother or anything of that sort. So I think law of attraction works in a way that you have mind peace more than, you know, just good things happening to you. That's the way I look at it, because not always like good thoughts get you good things, but good thoughts make you feel very peaceful at heart. You don't have all this negativity going on in your brain, which will automatically kill you, ruin your day. Whatever comes your way, you're not going to appreciate it and everything. When was the first time you experimented with makeup? I think the first time I experimented with makeup was when I was 19 18 19. That actually, you know, I didn't even know things existed. I just thought, I mean, I knew in a certain point, but I never like physically knew what was foundation, concealer, etc. I think Instagram just got a new world to me. So I think 19 was the time when I first, like, you know, tried makeup. I remember the first foundation I bought also. I think it was a concealer stick or something from Maybelline, and the first foundation was from Lakme, some $200 or something, and I just wanted to try it. Next question is, how was your graduation and how old are you? I think it's a very, you know, common question. I'm 22, soon to be 23. Next week, July 3rd is my birthday. So I think this video will be up. Yeah, obviously tomorrow I'll upload it. Yeah, so my birthday is coming. So I'll turn 23, but now I'm 22. And about my graduation, I love like my college. I love, back when I was in Pune, I think I didn't appreciate it a lot. But I do, like, I had really good friends. I do really love my engineering. I had, like, really, really good times. I didn't like, obviously, going to college. But I had really good set of friends. I love when I would do it again if I could. I really love my graduation. So what's your top three in your bucket list? I have a lot of things on my bucket list, but I think things which can happen really soon, I will tell you like that, like which are possible in the near future. So three things I have, top three, like on my budget list, on my bucket list are: one, I want to visit Bali. Bali has been in my mind since so long. I really want to go to Bali. Two is hitting 100,000 on YouTube and Instagram. Three is I don't even remember what's the third one. Let me think. I think three would be, yeah, having my own vanity. I think that is going to come true like really soon because my house is under renovation. So yeah, I think these three things are my bucket list right now, which can be fulfilled in the near future, at least in maybe 1 year. How did you initiate it? Tell us your story, please. I think that only, like, Instagram kind of opened this new world, and I bought a lot of makeup and I wanted to try and have fun with it, so I started posting it. There's not really like big story behind it or anything. I just, you know, posted it. I didn't really think much or do much. I just posted my tutorial. If you hadn't gotten into makeup, what would you have been doing? If I didn't get into makeup, maybe like I just talk in terms of what I did. I did my engineering, so I would be like, you know, doing some job in somewhere, like maybe in operations or something like that. I don't want to do technical work. I hate technical work. Yeah, somewhere like, you know, related to math. I would like take a job which is related to math, because I really like math. Or else, if I have an option of what career I want to be, please, yeah. So if given an option of what career I can choose, I would be somewhere, you know, in a research part, like where, you know, doing research about things like, you know, for skincare, makeup. Like, I would be in the production part of, you know, maybe like in that pharmacy, making a product type. Just using the Laura Mercier powder. So yeah, you were in which, I answered the other question, but I didn't answer which college. You were in which college and what course did you pursue? So I was in Symbiosis Institute of Technology, Lavale, Pune. I did my engineering in electronics and telecommunication. So there's a lot of questions about, are you dating someone? Do you have a boyfriend? These are like a lot of common questions. Guys, I will tell you one thing. If I had a boyfriend, and if I, you know, was comfortable showing, like, you know, that person on camera, then you would have already seen him. If I don't, then it could be that because I cannot show it or because I don't have. So what is the point of asking? What is the point of asking? So that is my answer. Somebody said, tell us about your sisters or siblings. So I have two siblings. I'm the youngest one. I have two elder sisters. So first sister, you see in my story, she's differently abled. She was born that way. She is 20. I'm 22, she's 5 years old. She's 27 years old. So yeah, that is my elder sister. The second sister I have, like, you know, the second elder sister, she's in the US, she did her master's, she's working there. So yeah, those are my two sisters. I'm the youngest one. I have only like two siblings. So I get asked this a lot, that did I do any course before, you know, like for makeup or anything? I really didn't do, guys. I just learned my makeup out of YouTube, you know, trying different things, testing different things, seeing so many techniques, learning so many things. So I didn't really learn from anywhere. I just learned it from YouTube. Didn't you ever get a chance to work in movies or music videos? Since my Instagram has picked up, a couple of people asked me to do short films. I don't know, it didn't really interest me. Maybe it's not like I don't like acting. I don't know, at that point I was just not interested in it. So fun fact, you guys, I never spoke about this. Nobody knows about this except for like my friends or something. So as a child, I was a child actor. So I think I was in my second standard or something. I acted in a couple of serials in Telugu. I don't really have any memory of it. I have a couple of, photos, and I do remember a couple of things, like, but not like a lot. My mom only reminds me of things I did or anything like that. So I'll put pictures here if you, you know, want to see that. Yeah, I acted like I think for a few episodes in a few serials when I was a kid, and then my dad was like, no, that industry is not good, don't go there. So again, I stopped. I think it was that, and you know, like back then, my mom used to take me to all the shoots. My sister, elder sister, needs constant, like, you know, support. Like, she, obviously, she's differently able, she cannot do things on her own. So she, whenever I had a shoot, like, she had to get somebody at home to take care of her, and we have to travel for so far. And my dad used to not live with us that time. Like, his work was in some other state, so he used to be there. My mom has to take me. So all those things, and I don't know. They told me, like, there were things like, you know, whose mother is prettier, so let's pick that child. So such things, that my dad was not comfortable with it. He's like, you know, concentrate on your studies more. So they removed from it. So I just did a couple of things here and there. So I'll just quickly do my eyebrows, everything off camera, and we'll get to eyes. I think this will already be a very long video. So let me just do these things off camera and I'll be back. Now I don't really know what look to do, because I had something in mind, but I wore this stupid blue and I don't want to change it up. So I don't know what to do. Probably I'll just do something blue. So I'm just thinking I'll go with something blue. I'm going to use this Morphe 35B palette. So somebody asked how to overcome a toxic relationship. My boyfriend mistreated me for the first time. What should I do? Should I forgive him? I can't really comment on that, because I don't really know the whole story, or it's not my place to tell. But I'll tell you one thing. If it's mistreating physically, or he's abusive towards you or anything, I don't think anybody deserves a second chance. Like, if it's that type of thing, or if just like he messed up, he, like, you know, didn't talk to you, or he forgot to, like, you know, you know what I mean, like, you know, silly things, or if it's like really some serious shit, I don't think, because that is a behavior which can lead to more cruel things. So if it's like that, anything abusive, anything violent, then please stay away from them. Like, they are not, you know, ideal. You're not supposed to be around that people. It will be harmful for you, your mental state and your physical state. These men are not worth it. And one more thing is, you know, if you love yourself, you will never ever put yourself through something which is harming you, like, mentally and physically. Like, stay away. You don't deserve to be unhappy. You don't deserve to, you know, be with somebody who is that toxic. If you went through bullying or harassment, please tell. I think that story is for a different time, different place. I don't know if I'm, like, you know, in that place to talk about things yet. Yeah, like, I've never been bullied, thank God, touch wood. But yeah, there are, like, it's not bullying exactly, that things about my childhood, but I will talk when I think I am ready. With how many followers did you start this with? I had, I think, around 400 followers, just of my friends and acquaintances. And then I started from 300-400 followers. I was never a famous kid. I was never famous in school, never famous in college, never. I was never a famous kid. So I was just like, I have certain number of my people. I only had them as my followers. What is the biggest dating lesson you have learned? I don't think this is something I've learned, but this is something I preach, and I wish people do this a little more, is that nobody should have control of the relationship. Two people must be running it. One cannot have an upper hand in it. And I think respect is something, like, you know, if your partner doesn't respect you, your opinions, or what you want to do with your life, or where you want to do what, like, if your partner doesn't respect it and doesn't understand it, I think, you know, it's a very off thing. Like, it's not how it's supposed to be. You're supposed to be mutually strong. One is not supposed to have the power on the other person. So I think that is something a lot of people have to preach. I think that is when a relationship becomes very you know, easier. Like, you know, a lot of things, like, if you have respect for each other, I don't think there is much left to do that makes a really good relationship. Having your opinions, having your own life, yet, you know, being together, that is something it takes a lot of practice and a mental state to get in there, but that is something you always have to do. You have to have mutual respect, mutual understanding. Nobody has to have, like, a power, or nobody has to be dominating. I meant to say that, you know, there should always be a perfect balance. Like, if you want to pursue your career or something, if you wanna, like, you know, go to some college, you wanna do something, like, the person cannot, you know, ask you not to do that, because it's your life at the end of the day. If given a chance to work as a makeup artist in Hollywood, would you go ahead? I think I would love to, but at the end of the day, my main goal is, you know, creating content, YouTube, Instagram, because this is what makes me happy. This is something which I love to do more than just being a makeup artist. I think content creation is my main thing. Like, I would love to do it, but at the end of the day, I know know I would definitely come back to this because it's something I really, really love doing. Should I add purple? I don't know. I think I'll ruin it. I think I'll go in with black. Maybe I'll just do. I will just use this. No, but I think it looks same. Somebody asked, what is the one quality your future beau must possess? So I think one thing which is very important to me is having my own space. I don't like when somebody is too much, you know, into it, like too nosy, like not like that. Like I would love like always being that person, but I don't like being questioned a lot. I don't like, you know, there is a limit between, like, I think there's a balance between how much, you know, space I need. I always like to have, like, even when I chill with my friends or anything, I can be with somebody for 2 days. But after that, I need a whole day for myself to, you know, to do what I want to do. And then again, I can get back to that person and again do something. When I'm with that person, it's not like I'm, you know, like making an effort or anything. I don't like too like a person to just come away, take all my space, and be too nosy, ask too many questions or anything like that. Maybe I think so. That is one thing. Respect and space, I think, are something I would look in any relationship, not only this. My makeup looks so crappy. I don't think I've ever done a look which looks this ugly. What would I do if I won lottery? Top three purchases. First thing. I don't think I would like to purchase anything. Like I said, I want to go to places, I want to travel. Second, maybe I would love to buy a G-Wagon. G-Wagon is on my list. I think like someday I really want to buy a G-Wagon, or maybe like, you know, if it is in you know, if it even exists by the time I become that rich, I will definitely buy it. And one more is maybe like a own house or an own car. Maybe I think so. Those things are not something which are so important to me, but like if given a chance, like why not, why wouldn't I not buy it? Somebody asked, what is my moon sign? So astrology is something I am so intrigued about. I love people I can talk astrology to. So Raksha, like if you guys saw my previous video, that's my best friend. We both talk about astrology a lot. We talk of a lot of things, and then always you end up talking about astrology, something which is very intriguing. I really, really love, like it makes me really interested in it. So my moon sign is Gemini, but my sun sign is Cancer. So basically now my birthday is coming. I think this video is just about me advertising that my birthday is coming, but anyway, yeah, my moon sign is a Gemini and my sun sign is a Cancer. I think I'll just finish the rest of the look and I'll be back and we'll wrap this up. So yeah guys, that's it for the look. This is probably the worst look I ever did. I'm not even going to try and fix it because it looks really bad. So I want to add falsies, but I'm like, I'm going to remove it in 10 minutes and this is not even a tutorial, so you know, never mind. But yeah, sorry for the makeup, let's just ignore the makeup. This is not about makeup. So anyways, that's it for the video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. It'll mean the world to me, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.